Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Edward Klobuchar, and I have the distinct honor and privilege of serving as the city manager for the city of Hazel Park. Today, we are gathered to commemorate the service of the fine men and women of the United States Armed Forces, and we're here to honor those men and women who lost their lives defending the freedom. We're joined here in the ceremony today by our outstanding mayor, Navy Corpsman and former Detroit EMS first responder, Jeff Keaton, Mayor Pro Tem Mike Webb, Councilman Andy LaCuro, Councilman and U.S. Army veteran Tom Selma, Councilman Beth Holland. We are also joined by Chief of Police Martin Barnum, Fire Chief Rich Story, Recreation Director Serene Papakia. From the Hazel Park Board of Education, we are joined by School Board President Rachel Knopf, Vice President Beverly Hemp, Secretary Chuck Hempel, Treasurer Rosemary Hammonds, Board Trustee Laura Atkins, Board Trustee Sue Hempel, and Board Trustee Christy Schlack. We're also joined by our hardworking Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Amy Krupe. Today, we would like to especially acknowledge the veterans of the City of Hazel Park for their service to our country. And I would like to ask our Mayor Jeff Keaton to say a few words.
Thank you, Ed. We're here today, obviously, to memorialize those fallen soldiers that kept our freedom throughout the years. I think we should also, even though we have Veterans Day and Memorial Day and days that we honor the men and women of the armed forces, we should also honor those who didn't give their lives, the ones who saved the lives of others, the ones who fought side by side with those who lost their lives. We're proud to have people who have come back to our community, who have fought for us, and we appreciate everything that they have done. So with that, I would like to introduce from the City Ed Church, Craig Brundridge, for the benediction.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Let's bow our heads in prayer. Dear Lord God, we come before you this day, and we recognize that Memorial Day is not simply just the beginning of summer, but it is a time for us to stop and to remember, to be grateful for those who have fought for the freedom and all the freedoms that we enjoy. Lord God, it is because of those men and women, those brave first responders, both in the past and in the present, that we are able to have parades, enjoy family, do cookouts, and stop and take time to remember this morning. And so, Father, we thank you for the good weather. We thank you for the good day that we will have. But we thank you so much for those who have given their lives and those who have, as Mayor said, not given their lives, but fought bravely. We'd like to pray and ask you, God, to be very special to those wounded warriors who have come home, who are suffering and battling through difficulty. And we lift up to you, Lord, this day, the opportunity and just the remembrance of those who have given us the freedom and fought for what we enjoy so much. We talk about the theme this year is the progress, 75 years progress of the city and all that we've accomplished. And we are grateful, Lord, for the way that you've blessed this city. Continue to bless us, we pray. And we also look back and think of the things that the city was built on, the faith, and the hard work of people. And we pray, Lord, that you just continue that on. We look to you and lift this up to you, Lord. In the name of Christ, we pray. Amen.
Military, take charge.
Dead! Hunt! Present arms!
This concludes the 2017 Memorial Day laying of the wreath memorial ceremony. I invite all of you to enjoy the Hazel Park Memorial Day Parade and the carnival afterwards. Thank you all for coming. And thank you, brave men and women of the United States Armed Forces.
Dismissed.
Thank you. life.
Okay, here we go. Hey. This is the fun part.
Slow down.